Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss some more management case studies, and as I have told you already in the past lessons that management holds one of the most importance when it comes to RBI as well as SEBI examinations, because almost 45 to 50% of the entire paper of financial management, finance and management comes out of management. Therefore, it's important that we discuss and understand case studies of management with twin objectives. The first objective is to understand what kind of questions can be framed from these case studies, and the second objective will be to understand the approach you need to follow in order to be able to answer these case studies, answer these questions in the correct manner. Okay, because following these case studies or trying to answer the questions based on these case studies is a lot different from just reading management or just following doing the conventional questions. The first question for today, this is a case study, and I would request you to pause this video for a while and go through this case study before we take up the question. I will be highlighting certain keywords and then we will take up the question. So pause the video for a while, read the entire case study. These are the keywords that we have. It's about James Washington, who is a young graduate from Northview's management trainee program, and he's recently taken up manager's job at the organization service center. Now, James is the manager at one of the service centers, and Dorothy is an old employee at the same service center, but she's not the manager there, and therefore he's in a tussle with Dorothy because Dorothy is an experienced and an old employee there. James began to feel that Dorothy was resisting his taking over leadership of the service center and was working behind his back to undermine his authority. Now, this is a major keyword here. James threatened to fire her at one point, but subsequently she became passive and withdrawn. That means she became indifferent to his directions. And then she also started challenging him through a lot of activities that she started inculcating into or involving into. Okay, so this is the major keyword that we have. Let's have a look at the question. How should James handle the situation? What should James be doing? So this is a conclusive statement which is asking you to understand and identify what should be James doing now that he's facing this problem. The options are: James should immediately fire Dorothy because such a behavior can be adapted by other employees if not punished. Looks very practical and very good option. James should talk to Dorothy in private in order to understand the real reasons behind her behavior before taking any action. James should report Dorothy's behavior to the central office and wait for their response. James should hire a private counselor because Dorothy is a valuable employee and her absence can affect efficiency of the service center. Counseling her might help release the stress she is facing. James should recommend Dorothy to the manager, to be the manager of another service center, because that is her ultimate objective as per James. Now, this is incorrect because that is the job of top management or the HR department and not the job of James. James should report Dorothy's behavior to the central office and wait for their response. Not a very efficient and an effective response, because in this way James is not acting as a leader, but is just trying to pass on the buck of the problems that he's facing. Okay. Now, hiring a counselor is not such a bad idea, but hiring a private counselor is not a good idea, because that means James is going to be, bearing the brunt, monetary brunt of that private counselor. So understanding these keywords is important. That's why this also becomes not such a good option. Now, we are left with two options, A and B. Should immediately fire Dorothy because such a behavior can be adapted by other employees. Now, this looks very strict and a very good option, but it is not. Why? Because Dorothy is an important employee for the organization, as is mentioned in the case study, and she's one of the oldest employees in that branch in that particular service center. Therefore, firing her would affect the efficiency of the service center. James should talk to Dorothy in private in order to understand the real reason. Now, this is the immediate response that should be followed by James, after which the other responses that have been mentioned here can actually be followed. But this should be the immediate response that should be followed or that should be adopted by James, after which he can go forward and probably try and use some other methods if it does not work. So the first and foremost method should be to talk to Dorothy in private and understand what are the reasons that she's involving herself in such a behavior. I hope you've understood it. Let's come to the second case study that we have. Please go through it. Pause the video for a while. Let us have a look at some of the keywords. It's about Peter Gilmore, who is an energetic and capable manager. Peter worked hard and diligently, regularly putting in 10-hour days and working on the weekends as well. Because of his dedication, Peter had been rewarded with ever-increasing responsibilities and promotions. Keywords here. Now, Peter has become manager of a division and now he is trying to lead certain people and he is telling them or communicating to them what kind of leadership method does he follow and what are the expectations that he has with the employees, with the subordinates. I expect the same from subordinates, which means he's saying that if my boss has given me an assignment, I always worked as hard and as fast as I could to complete it perfectly and on time. He delegated projects easily and would expect them to get done. When he handed out an assignment, he didn't expect to have to deal with it until the employee brought back the completed task within a reasonable time. So he is delegating the work, but the purpose of delegating work is not to enjoy himself. That is an important point that you need to keep in mind, but to ensure that the subordinates are very efficient in their nature and so that he can also use his time better. For this type of supervisory leadership to work successfully, what kind of relationship must Peter Gilmore have with his subordinates? What kind of relationship must Peter have with his subordinates? So the options are, Peter must have a threatening relationship with his subordinates because people inherently dislike work. Is threatening them going to work in this scenario wherein Peter Gilmore wants to delegate the tasks and ensure that they are responsible enough? No, it is not going to work. Certainly out of question, therefore this can be eliminated. Peter must have a fatherly relationship with his subordinates so that they can go to him for any doubts and rely on his leadership for successful completion of tasks. He does not want them to rely on his leadership, but he wants them to be autonomous in nature, to be responsible enough to be able to do tasks on their own. Peter must have complete delegatory relationship with his subordinates so that he can enjoy the fruits of his hard work and make them work for him. Now, argument is good, that means that Peter must have complete delegatory relationship, but the reason behind it is incorrect because he does not want to enjoy the fruits. He does not want to rest. He just wants them to be more productive. That makes our last option the correct option, which is Peter must have a very trusting relationship with his subordinates where he can rely on them to complete the work done without his review, and the subordinates are able to take responsibility for their work. All the positive words which were mentioned in the case study. So our answer is D. Another question based on the same case study again. We have the same keywords being highlighted again. Okay, let's have a look at the question. What problems can be faced by Peter due to his style of leadership? So what are the problems that Peter can face due to his styles of leadership? Number one, if there is a question mark on capability and commitment of subordinates, Peter's style of leadership might not be effective. That means if the subordinates are not capable enough or are not committed enough, then Peter's style of leadership will fail. If the employees cannot be trusted with delegation of responsibility, Peter's entire style of managing is compromised. That means if employees cannot be delegated responsibility, Peter's style of leadership will fail. If employees are not trained well in taking up responsibility and working on time, Peter's leadership style might be ineffective. Okay, so these are the three options that have been given. I want you to understand and answer the from the options available here, the correct one that you think. The answer to this question is that all three. What are the problems that Peter can face? Yes, if people are not, the subordinates are not capable and committed, then Peter's style will not be effective. Yes, if the employees are not cannot be trusted with delegation, yes, Peter's style will fail. If the employees are not trained well in taking up responsibility and working on time, Peter's style will fail. Therefore, the answer is that 1, 2 and 3 are the problems Peter can face. This is another case study that we have, the fourth one for today. I want you to go through this case study, pause the video for a while. Let me come to the keywords that I have highlighted here and then we'll move to the question. It is about Mary, who in her organization began taking longer lunch breaks, longer, started sleeping at her desk, started coming drunk to work and started taking a lot of holidays as well without any reason, just saying that she was sick. Mary was short-tempered with co-workers, so her behavior with co-workers is also changing. The reason given is a single mother of two teenage girls. She also seemed to have problems completing her work after returning from lunch. That means not only is she behaving inappropriately, her work is also getting affected. Okay, now what is the question? What should be Helen, who is the boss of Mary here, what should be Helen's next step to ensure that the company doesn't lose a good employee? That means that Mary has been identified as a good employee and Mary doesn't continue with her irresponsible behavior. Helen should refer Mary to counseling through employee assistance program. Remember that the word private is not mentioned here. And the case also talks about employee assistance program. Therefore, this option looks very promising. Helen should not waste time and money of the company and ask for voluntary retirement of Mary. Not good option, because the question says that the organization does not want to lose a good employee. Helen should teach Mary a lesson and get her fired at the earliest. Not a good option. Helen should privately talk to Mary and counsel her to handle her personal affairs in a more mature manner. This also looks a very promising option. So we have A and D. Which one is more effective in this scenario? Because Helen has been trying to deal with Mary for a long time. It's been almost a year, mentioned in the case study itself, that she's been trying to deal with. The entire chain of events is mentioned. Therefore, Helen has been trying to talk to Mary and understand and teach, probably try to make her understand that her work is important for a very long time. Therefore, this is not going to work. Therefore, in this situation, A is a more effective answer. Now, remember that there was a previous case wherein the boss had to try and talk to Dorothy in private because he had not done so at all and he was a new manager there. But here the situation is different. So that is how you have to understand the situation and then come to the answer. The last case study that we have for today, please pause the video and watch this entire, read this entire case study. Let us come to the keywords that we have. It is about Jerry, director of a marketing for a large toy company. Now, his team consists entirely of white males. He tends to promote, the reason given by him is that he tends to promote people who are like him. And he also justifies this by saying that we are not violating any law. Now, the boss that he has says that, okay, you can move forward with the same strategy because we have big marketing plans for the coming fiscal year and we want to move overseas into the overseas market. Therefore, I do not want to mess around with the method of leadership that you have because it works. The question is, which of the following benefits of diversity of workforce is ignored by Jerry? Certainly, because he's hiring and promoting only white males, that means he's losing out on females, losing out on colored people. Therefore, what are the benefits of diversity of workforce that are being ignored by Jerry and Robert in the above case? Employees of the same sex, culture and race tend to be a part of groupthink more often than a workforce consisting of employees from different backgrounds. This, of course, certainly is a correct option because people of the same culture, same race, same sex tend to, chances are higher, they will have similar thinkings, or on certain points they will have similar methods of thinking. Therefore, they will indulge themselves into groupthink. Diverse teams lead to more innovative and have more effective ideas in implementation, and especially when they're trying to get into overseas market, they should be understanding the importance of diverse team. This is correct. In a global marketplace, a company that employs a diverse workforce is better able to understand the demographics of global consumer marketplace. Yes, a lot of companies in the past have failed just because they have not understood the demographics of global consumer marketplace or that local consumer in that particular area, and therefore this is a valid point. A diverse workforce consisting of employees from both sexes result in social and personal relationships at workplace that is often beneficial for the employer as it results in less turnover risk. Now, there is no direct connection between personal relationships between males and females in a particular company and the labor turnover, and this is not even an advantage for the firm because those social and personal relationships might affect the efficiency and effectiveness of the workforce. Therefore, it is not always a good thing. Okay, so a professional relationship should be mentioned, and we should try and avoid as much as possible creating personal relationships. Therefore, 4 is incorrect. Only 1, 2 and 3 are the benefits of a diverse workforce which are being ignored by Robert and Jerry. Okay, so this was about today's session wherein we discussed a lot of case studies. These case studies will help you understand what are the links that can be created between a case and the concepts behind those cases, concepts, management concepts that can be used, and at the same time what kind of questions can be created through these cases which can be thrown at you in the examination and which has been done in the past as well. I hope you liked the lesson. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to the session. I will be coming up with such beautiful videos, such amazing videos consisting of a lot of personally created cases which can be very useful for your upcoming examinations. All the very best. Take care.